Hey guys, what's up again? From Breda in the Netherlands, we have this brewery. It's called Frontaal. And they made a rather special one. Huh? You might not believe it, but it is a white stout.
What?
I don't know what they mean by the white stout. I think it is not colorized. But we're gonna see. It seems to be amber colored, what is already also rather strange. But it has cocoa nibs in there. And also we have some timid peppers.
Uh-oh.
To this one. 10.5% ABV it is. And there is some special coffee in there. But also, like you can see here, special chocolates from, yeah, toffees. You will see toffees. Chocolate toffees. I must look at it. Friandries. Chocolates. That's the part where they get their chocolates, and you can see it on the label. This is the guy who make the toffees at the chocolate factory. I think it's a rather small factory, or like a guy who is working on his own chocolates. It will be more known in the Netherlands than in Belgium, of course. So we're gonna try it, we're gonna open it and see how this one looks. That's the thing I'm really curious to see, how this one will look. And also taste, of course, the peppery mouthfeel. I always like it, to be honest, in a stout. Okay, this one, it is not brown, it's really amber indeed. So they were totally right about that part. And that's a really strange thing to see for a stout, guys. Look at this. It is a see-through amber, like a little bit hazy. Put your two finger head to it, 2.5 maybe. There is some carbonation rolling up on the glass. I can see it. Maybe you guys can see it, but I can really see it. The carbonation is rolling up the glass. Awesome thing. The white stout. Whoever thought, guys, this would one day happen. And I like these innovators who made these new beers, who experiment to make next level flavors or make awesome beers. Like the thing they did wasn't a hit, of course, with the glitters, the eatable glitters and stuff. I didn't like that really, but it's innovative and I like that. Guys who try to be different in the scene, in the beer scene, so okay. First on the nose, guys, we're gonna try it. Cheers. I get loads of vanilla. Is this really present, the vanilla? Your cacao nibs, you can get the coffee. The chocolate I don't really get, but we're gonna see in the taste. It smells, does smell like a stout, but then again, if you're talking about a black stout, I think the malt base will be really different because they won't use that roasted malts in here. And the roasted malts, the dark malts, will make the beer, of course, darker. And I think they used other malts to this base because you can see the color. It isn't a normal stout. And you expect this with these malts they used in a stout. It will be darker, of course, like dark brown or even too black. This one totally doesn't have that. It goes really to an amber beer, like you can see. So I'm excited, guys. I am excited to try it. Cheers, guys. Really special. Really special. It's like a smooth stout with vanilla, the cacao, you can get the chocolate. Now I can get it really well. That's the first thing that hits you, the chocolate and the vanilla. The cacao nibs, then the coffee. That's the first things you get. Then, now it comes, the booziness and the peppery, timut peppers. It comes in now, it comes in. It's slight warming, it's really in balance. It does have that thing of that red ale. It does make me think of the red ales from England also a little bit. If you take away, of course, the chocolate and the coffee and those cacao nibs, it's more like an ale, and it goes a little bit to an English style ale, the amber colored beers. So the malt base is totally different. It is still a stout because they used ingredients that's also been used in a stout, and I think, yeah, it's quite exceptional to brew things like this. So that's a plus for me, for sure. Is it the best beer? Like, no, but yeah, like I told you guys, I like it, how they twisted the style, and I'm gonna give this 7.25 to 7.5 again out of 10. So guys, it's also a little bit spicy. That's the thing I also want to mention. If you can find it, try it and tell me in the comment section what do you think about it. And I want to ask you one more question, guys. I have now 229 subscribers, if I'm correct. I think, yeah. So I really want to make it 230. So if anyone is watching and want to see my reviews that are coming, because I'm gonna start with a Beery Christmas again. That's a beer advent calendar, and we're gonna start from tomorrow if it's available, because they still got to deliver it to my place and I'm still waiting for it. It was gonna be delivered today, but they also have quite some problems with the packages to be delivered at everyone's place, because it's really busy now. And I'm gonna start tomorrow. I'm gonna do two of them then, from the Beery Christmas. It is an awesome calendar, beer calendar. I got to mention this. It is an awesome beer calendar, and that's how I started, to be honest. Like, if you go back a year, I always also started with that Beery Christmas calendar, and this year it has not 24 beers, but also to be enjoyed at Christmas itself. So it has 25 beers, what is a nice thing. And there are all different beers from many different countries. They put their work into this calendar, do trust me. And it's still available now at Hopt in Belgium. It is still available. You guys from other countries can also buy it at Hopt. They do send it to other countries, of course. And yeah, it's 70 euros. I think it was 70 euros, but it's really cheap for 25 special beers. And a lot of them are brewed for this calendar especially. So it's a unique chance and still available. That's a rather strange thing, because every year it was sold out. If you look at November, when you try to buy it online in November, it was always sold out, and now it's still available. So hurry up, guys, and try to buy it, and do get me one more subscriber. That's all I'm asking for now, of course, because I still want this channel to grow and to keep my language, the English language, a little bit better. So we're still upgrading. If you look at my first videos, you will see it is not that fluid, but it's hard when you're from Belgium and try to get to starting these reviews is nothing, but to get really fast the words in your head is really much harder, because you haven't planned anything and you're thinking, oh, it's gonna be really fast and really smooth, but it's not like that most of the time, of course. Now and then you will see I will cut the video because I made a mistake, a small mistake. It does happen now and then, but not as many as when I started. So I'm slightly going up, evolving, like they call it. So I'm gonna round it up, because I'm rambling on again about different things than about this beer. I'm sorry about that. So tomorrow I will start with a beer calendar. I don't know when I'm gonna post it, but I'm gonna do two reviews tomorrow, But then this beer might be also not posted today when we are the 1st of December today. It might be later, of course. But you know me, I'm rather fast with my videos. I did do one beer a day, every day, when I started. I'm gonna do it again now with a beer Christmas. Just do one. And you can see it. I will hold it here, the beer Christmas, and get one out. And you will see how it works. So we're gonna do that, guys. So keep on watching. And don't forget, a beer day keeps the terror away. Cheers.